presented by ChurchTechU, it's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, how to use Planning Center Online to sync instances of ProPresenter. Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I teach you all about ProPresenter. My name's Paul Alan Clifford. And before we get started, if you like this content and you want to get updates in the future, go ahead and subscribe and click on the little bell icon so that I can get you access to these tutorials quickly and easily. One of the great things that they added in ProPresenter 7.7 and has continued on to 7.7.1, which is current as I'm recording this, is the ability to sync presentations from one instance of ProPresenter to another. So you could make your presentations at home or in your office or wherever, and then have them show up in ProPresenter at church, so saving you a bunch of time and not having to buy an additional service to make that happen. So I thought that we'd head over to my computer and take a look at just how you can make that happen. So here we are in ProPresenter. First thing you're going to need to do is make sure that you are connected to Planning Center Online. So create an account if you don't have one already. They do have a free trial, so you can see if this is right for you. In fact, that's what I'm using, as limited as I use Planning Center personally. My team has an account, but for these tutorials, I've got the most basic kind of account. So let's go into ProPresenter, then Preferences, then Services. And I've said this in the other Planning Center tutorials that I made. Think of services not as church services, but as external services that interface with ProPresenter. So we're going to click on that, and that brings up this page. Make sure you're logged in. If you're not logged in, you'll have to click the button that's right here. It won't say log out. It'll say log in. Put in your name and email address. And then you want to check the appropriate things here. For this use, there are a couple of things that are absolutely necessary. You would probably want to automatically check for plan updates if you're doing this in a different location, so that reminds you to update the stuff. Match presentations in library. That's good. Show historical service plans. You don't need that checked for this. The historical service plans can get ungainly if you've used PCO for a long time. So make arrangements from sequences. You probably want to do that. And automatically upload presentations and media. If this is the machine that you're making the presentations on, you definitely want that checked. If you're never making changes on this machine, this is a presentation only machine, you're not going to change any of the stuff, then you can leave that unchecked. I would probably have it checked just in case you made a change, but keep in mind that that would override the Planning Center changes. And automatically download presentations and media. Yes, you definitely want this checked, because that's how we're going to bring presentations into Planning Center. So we're going to do that, and into ProPresenter from Planning Center is what I meant to say. So now we can click that. Now to add in a Planning Center playlist, you click this little plus button up here and Planning Center service. So we do that. Select the appropriate one. Let's do this one. And that should bring it in. It should match everything. Since I've brought this in before, it's asking me, hey, there's some duplicates here. What should I do? You could write over what you have, create a new version, or use existing. I'm going to say a new version this time. And I should have clicked apply all so that did all that for me. So now we've got the playlist ready to go up here. You'll notice that my slide loop is populated and ready to go. I've got my first song with the default arrangement from Planning Center Online. I've got my announcement slides. I've got Amazing Grace, but I've got a little bit of a problem here. I named the arrangement default arrangement in Planning Center, but I didn't actually create that. So what you would need to do is go into the arrangements master and select the appropriate arrangement. I'm just going to go with the master just because the arrangements functionality is a totally different tutorial, so let's not dive into that. But that brings us up to here. This is my sermon. Then I've got a closing and a slide loop. Let's say that I don't want to actually show the closing. Well, what I can do is right-click, select Hide Item, and then that is out of that. Let's say I didn't want to show the announcements. I could do the same thing. Right-click, Hide Item, there. And now neither of those are showing. If I want to show them again, down here, two additional hidden items. Well, I can click on that and unhide and select one or both or however many you've hidden and unhide that, or I can unhide all of them in one fell swoop, just like that. So that does all that. If it's the case that you need to do some linking of things, let's say that there was another song that I'd added in Planning Center and it wasn't here, I could do a search for that in my libraries and drag it in, and then that would link there, and then it would upload back to ProPresenter. So maybe you don't have that particular song in the office or at home because you know that it exists here. Well, you can upload it back into Planning Center, and then when you sync again, it will download from Planning Center to your other computer. So very powerful feature that enables you to do something without buying an additional service if you've already got Planning Center Online. If you like this content, I bet you'd like my ProPresenter 7 Quick Start course. So head on over to tdm.fyi/pro7quick. Give me your name and email address so that I can make a login for you. And I'll do just that, send you all the information, and you can watch that at your leisure. Until next time, this is Paul Alan Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.